Good morning, everybody. How are you doing this morning? It's good to see you. Are you ready to start our day? All right, let's stand up straight and tall. Reach up high to the sky, as high as you can reach. Get up on your tippy-tippy toes. And then I want you to bend down and touch the floor. When I get up, I'm thankful for a brand new day. When I get dressed, I'm thankful I can run and play. When I sit down to eat, I'm thankful for my food. But most of all, I'm thankful for a God that is so good. And God is good, and I'm so glad that He brought us together again today. Now, I've decided that I'm going to be the flag holder today. So, I have my flag right here. Are you still standing? Good job. Put your hand on your heart. And let's say the Pledge of Allegiance together. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. God bless America, land that I love. Stand beside her and guide her through the night with the light from above. From the mountains to the prairies to the oceans white with foam, God bless America, my home sweet home. God bless America, my home sweet home. Let's get ready and find out what the weather is doing today. What's the weather? What's the weather? What's the weather like today? Tell me, everyone, what's the weather? Can we go outside to play? All right, quick, everybody go look out your window and come back and tell me what you see. I'm going to do the same thing. All right, here is my weather window, and when I look outside, I see nothing but blue sky and lots of sunshine. So you can better believe that I'm going to get out there and do lots of gardening and playing today. I hope you will too. Do you remember that we're talking about transportation this week? What does that word mean? Transportation. It means moving things or people from one place to another. And we talked about trucks and cars and dump trucks the other day. Well, today we're going to talk about the things that go in the air and on the sea. So we'll talk about airplanes and helicopters, rocket ships and sailboats, freighters that carry things long ways over the ocean. And maybe, let's see, what else can we think of on the ocean? A motorboat or a kayak or a paddleboard or a canoe. I'm sure all of you have seen those probably around. But let's talk about airplanes first. Have you ever been on an airplane? I've been on a couple, not recently, but I've been on a couple of airplanes. And when I get on an airplane, sometimes they ask me for one of these little blue books. This is called a passport. And that's what we need when we leave our great country of the United States of America and go somewhere far, far away and visit. This tells them who I am, and it also tells them that I get to come back when I'm finished on my trip. And if I look inside, it'll tell me right here in the corner that I live in the USA, the United States of America. And this passport has a quick picture of me. I'm not going to show it to you because I don't like that picture. And then when I go to different places, I get stamps in my book. And you can see that little stamp right there that I got when I went to the country of Mexico the last time. So passports is something that we might need if we take a trip on an airplane or even on a boat, depending on where the boat is going. Have you been on an airplane? Where did you go? Tell me. Oh, you went to Florida? Oh, I heard Illinois. Has anybody been to Utah? I think I know someone that goes to Utah in our class. California. That's a lot of places. And some of those are far, far away, too. Well, let's get started with a song about airplanes. Stand up straight and tall. Get your wings out and let's get ready to fly. All right, you ready to fly? Let's go. Get your wings out. Land on the ground. Jump out. Fun flying in an airplane. I hope you had fun too. But now we're going to talk about something that is not in the air, but on the seas. What do you see here? Some boats. What kind of boats are those? Does anybody know? Those are sailboats. Let's count to see how many we have. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 little sailboats. Can you help me name the colors? All right, let's start up here. Blue, and this one is red. What color is this one? White. This one is yellow and green. Let's find out what these little sailboats are going to do. 5 fast sailboats are floating offshore. The yellow one sailed away. And now there are 4. The blue one sped away. And now we have 3. Can you count them? 1, 2, 3. Show me 3. Good job. The red one raced away. And now we have 2. The white one skimmed away. And now that left 1. The green one zipped away. And now there are none. And what is that number that we say when there are none? Zero. There are zero left. Good counting. I have a fun book about airplanes to read today, and I'm going to need your help in reading it because it has lots of clues and we have to figure some things out. And it's about a little white mouse named Maisie. I think you might recognize her. And the name of the book is Come Fly with Maisie. Let's get started. There's that little white mouse, Maisie. Come Fly with Maisie by Lucy Cousins. How will Maisie get to the airport? Here are some clues. A propeller, cloud, goggles, and vroom. How's she going to get there? By plane. Charlie wants to get to the farm. How will he get there? Here's our clue. A saddle, horseshoes, apples, and it makes the sound clip, clop, clip, clop. What do you think? I think you're right. It's a horse. Tallulah's ready to go to the moon. How will she get there? I see a spacesuit, some stars, a space helmet, and it makes whoosh sound. Did you say a rocket? There she goes. Cyril wants to get to the beach. How will he get there? Let's look at the clues. A boxcar, tracks, a smokestack, and it makes the sound toot, toot. Who said train? Oh, kiss your brain, you're so smart. Eddie is going to get to an island. How will he go? I see fish, an anchor, a porthole, which is a little window, and someone might say, ahoy! Eddie's going to take a boat. How will Ostrich get to the firehouse? I see a hose, a ladder, a helmet, and something that's going to make the noise, Nina, Nina, Nina. Who said fire engine? There it is. And now how will Maisie get back home with her friends? I see handlebars on a basket, a wheel, and it's going to make the sound ding, ding. Let's see. A bike. Look at all of those friends on Maisie's bike. Let's see how many friends there are. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I've never seen a bike that 6 people can ride on. That's pretty special, Maisie. Do you remember some time ago we were talking about community helpers? Well, I have some community helpers right here. Can you help me and tell me who they are? Let's start at the top. What job do you think that lady has? Yep, I see the police hat with her shield on there. I think she's a police officer. How about the next one? He has a bandana around his neck and a watch in his hand. I think he looks like a train engineer. You're right. How about this one? She has a straw hat and a pitchfork. What do you think she might work at? A farm. I think she might be a farmer, yes. And how about this one at the bottom? Everybody knows who that is with his axe and his fancy hat. A firefighter. Well, all of these workers help us in our community, but they also use transportation in their job. So here are some pictures of transportation, and we're going to figure out which job uses which transportation. So let's start with this one. What is that a picture of? A tractor. And it's green. I love it. So which one of those community helpers do you think uses the tractor? Oh, the farmer uses the tractor. Good job. Let's choose another one. How about this one? The one with the star. What is that? A police car. Yes. So which one of our transportation goes to the police car? Oh, our police officer uses transportation that is a police car. All right, next we have a fire truck. And who uses the fire truck? That's an easy one. The fireman. And last we have the train. And who do we know uses the train for transportation? Oh, the engineer. Very good. Good job matching our workers to their transportation. Do you know anybody that uses transportation in their job? Maybe the men who deliver the packages to your house or the mailman who brings the mail to our mailboxes? Lots of people use transportation in their work. It's a very important thing to have sometimes. You ready to do some science this morning? We're going to make a rocket ship, and I'm going to show you how, and then after I'm finished, I want you to go make one too, and then we're going to go outside and we're going to see if we can launch them. Are you ready to get started? All right, here's what you need. You need just a little piece of paper, some markers to decorate, some scotch tape, and a straw. Now, I don't have any plastic straws in my house anymore. We just have these fancy reusable straws, but any kind of straw will do. So I'm going to color my paper and make a design, and then I'll show you how to make it into a rocket ship. All right, I finished making my design, and look, I made a pattern. What colors did I use? Green, red, and blue. Green, red, blue. I made a pattern. So now what we're going to do is we're just going to wrap this around the straw, put on a little bit of tape, and then see what happens. All right, I'll show you in just a second. All right, I folded it around and made it into a little tube. I put some tape to hold it together, and then I folded the end over so that the one end is closed and one end is open. Then we're just going to slide it right onto the straw like that. And it's ready for launching. Do you want to see what happens? All right, let's go outside and find out. It's been another great day with you. All right, here we are outside. We're going to see how far our paper rocket will go up in the air. Now remember, we've taped it together and closed up one end. There's the open end. We're gonna put it on our straw, and I'm gonna step back so you can see the whole thing. All right. So there's my rocket and my straw. I'm gonna blow through the end, and let's see if it launches. Are you ready? 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, blast off! Ah! I want to see pictures of your big rockets too, so send them to me if you get a chance to do it today, okay? Bye! Oh, I'm so glad to see you. Let's say goodbye. Get our pinkies ready for our prayer. Pinkies up. Glory to God as the angels sing. Thanks be to God for everything. God, forgive me as I forgive others. Bless everyone, my sisters and brothers. And last of all, dear God, bless me. Amen. Have a great day, everybody. Go fly those rockets and send me a picture, okay? Bye-bye.